So we're going to, is it ready? Because I didn't click anything. Okay. All right. So we're going to get into our sermon, and our sermon is called what?
Praise.
The thing about it is this. Why do we praise? There's so many reasons. So many reasons why we praise. There's so many reasons why we praise.
Unit. I seen how we got
how we start doing things and how we start getting things done. It made us better. No, that word of God is true. All things work together for good.
Preach.
It didn't seem good at the time.
Preach, Bishop.
It didn't seem good. And those of you who are around and know what I'm talking about, you know it didn't seem good. But it worked to our good. It worked to our good. That's why we praise. Corrupt and get decayed and go away. It's not in that. It's in Him and Him alone. It's in Him whenever you think you're walking by yourself. When you think you're walking by yourself, it's Him.
Preach.
That's there to lift you up.
Amen.
It's Him. It's Him that does that. So that's why we praise.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord. So I want you to understand, what is your why? What is your why? Because if you think about it, if you look around you, there's lots of whys. Just consider yourself right now, as you are right now. If you're seeing me, that's your why. If you're able to hear me, that is your why.
Amen.
If you got clothes on your back, that is your why. If you got loved ones still living, that is your why. If you have room, if you got food, shelter, and clothing, that is your why. If you're in your right mind, that is your why.
Amen.
That is your why.
Preach.
So what am I talking about? That is your why to praise. That you have, and that is your why. That is your why. I'm not talking about the money that you have in the bank. If you got money in the bank, that's another reason why. But I'm not talking about that. I'm just talking about if you just look within yourself, if you just look within you, look at what you're able to do. If you, I know some of these young guys in here, and I think it's a good thing. I know you all go and get your swole on. You all be working out. That is your why. Because there's lots of people who can't do that. There's lots of people who can't move, who can't jump, who can't lift, who can't hold something. That's your why. That's your why. Don't get so clouded. Don't get your mind so clouded on looking at these external things. I'm talking about we just stay internal within ourselves. Internal within ourselves. We have a why. Because think about these things that you want so bad. Right? We know we want things. I want things too. Right? Some of you might want a beautiful car. Right? You might want this and not the other. But which one of these things that the Lord gave you would you be willing to give up? How many of you would be willing to give up your eyesight for the car? Okay. How many of you be willing to give up your legs and walking for the car? Come on now. This car, we're talking about a good car. We're talking about the best. Think about the best car possible. Lamborghini, if you want a Lamborghini. How many are you willing to give up your eyes for a Lamborghini? That's right. Can't even drive them. You gave them up. Right? But how many of you would be willing to give up your legs for a Lamborghini? All right. Okay. Well, we'll still try to keep you intact. I'll keep you intact on this one. You don't have to give up any body parts on this one. Okay. How many of you would be willing to give up the taste, your taste buds, and not be able to taste your food for a Lamborghini? I'm keeping my arms down. I don't care. I don't want to lose any limbs, but I don't want to give up my food either. Now, I'm telling you, that Lamborghini can stay where it's at. I want to taste my burgers off the grill. I want to be able to taste my ice cream or what have you. That's all right. I'm keeping my arms down because I ain't giving it up for no Lamborghini. And we're talking about these are the things that we have inside. I'm not even talking about outside stuff. These are the reasons why we pray. Thank you, Lord. These are the reasons. So we're going to turn to the Word of God quickly. If you can't get it as quickly as I'm reading it, that's fine. But it's on the board. You can look at it on your own. We're going to go to 1 Chronicles. 1 Chronicles. We're going to go to 1 Chronicles, chapter 16, verse 25. And it reads, "For great is the Lord. For great is the Lord. For great is the Lord and greatly to be praised."
Praise.
He is also to be feared above all gods. So that's why he's great. That's why he's great. Why should we esteem him? Because he's great. He's great. For great is the Lord. That's why we should esteem him. That's why we come in here and do what we do. That's why when you're at home and you're in your secret place and you're worshiping, right? That's why you do what you do. Because for he is great. He is great. We'll stay in 1 Chronicles. We can go to chapter 29, verses 12 through 13.
Amen.
"Both riches and honor come of thee." So, hey, listen. I asked you about the Lamborghini, but where does that come from? It comes from God, right?
Yeah.
It comes from God.
Amen.
Right? Both riches and honor come from thee, and thou reignest over all. Reignest over all. So that means that celebrity that you're esteeming, that athlete that you're esteeming, he's over them. So that means that, you know, we should be giving him the honor. We should be esteeming him.
Head above all. Amen.
"And in thy hand is power and might. And in thy hand is it, and in thy hand it is to make great." You hear that? "In his hand is to make great." So if you want to be great, quit trying to do it on your own. As we preached a while ago, quit trying to do it on your own. Right? You want to be great? Quit doing it on your own. He said, it's in his hands. In his hands. And right? He said, let's read it again. "And in thy hand it is to make great." It is to make great. "And to give strength unto all." And to give strength unto all. "Now therefore, O God, we thank thee and praise thy glorious name." Praise thy glorious name. Thank you, Lord. 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 Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. So that's why we do what we do. He makes us great, man. He makes us great. Right? Think about that. Who wouldn't want to give the honor to him, the worship to him?
Amen.
He makes us great. I know all these celebrities we're trying to esteem.
No.
All these celebrities we're trying to esteem and sports figures that we're trying to esteem. They don't make us great.
No.
We make them great.
Amen.
You hear me? We make them great.
Great.
Right? We make their name great, but they ain't making us great. But he makes us great. He makes us great. Thank you, Lord. We're going to go to Psalms 9, 1 through 4. Here we go. "I will praise thee."
Woo!
"I will praise thee."
Praise.
"I will praise thee, O Lord."
Hallelujah.
"O Lord, with my whole heart." So not half heart. Remember we talked about that before? You can't be halfway. You got to be 100%.
Amen.
"Say with thy whole heart." With my whole heart. With my whole heart, I will show forth all thy marvelous works.
Marvelous.
That's why we esteem him. That's why we worship him, because of his marvelous works. And I want to show forth all your marvelous works. Show forth all your marvelous works. "I will be glad and rejoice in thee. I will sing praises to thy name."
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Praises to thy name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. "O thou most high, when my enemies are turned back, they shall fall and perish at thy presence. For thou hast maintained my right and my cause." Who would want to esteem and worship God? "Thou sattest in the throne judging right." You got judges who don't judge right, and they want to be esteemed and honored, don't they? Mm. Your honor, your honor, your honor. And they sit up there acting like they're sort of like little gods, right? And like they don't even want to hear you. Oh, no, that's all right. What does that have to do? You can't even get a word in. Like, you can't even speak to them like a man. Well, if I can explain this to you, you got to go through all these procedures and motions and stuff.
Praise be.
And you got God, where it says, thou sattest in the throne judging right. No wonder why we honor and worship God Almighty. Psalms 9 and 11. Sing praises to the Lord. Which dwell in Zion. Declare among the people his doings. That's right. So we're not going to keep it all into ourselves, right? Right? We just got finished singing a song. I got to praise on the inside. I can't keep it to myself. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. And you're going to let people know. Right? You're going to let them know. Right? And there's another song. Everybody ought to know. Thank the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you. Let's go to songs. We got a lot of songs because you know why?
Praise.
Oh, here we go. The David was a praise warrior, right? Yeah. Praise warrior. That's right. So we're going to go. So we're staying in Psalms. We're staying in Psalms quite a bit in this sermon. Quite a bit. So we're going to go to Psalms 27 and 6. And now shall my eyes, and now shall my head, and now listen to this. And now shall my head be lifted up. My head shall be lifted up above my enemies, round about me. Right? Woo! Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle the sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yea, I will sing praise unto the Lord. That's right. My head is lifted up. Thank you, Lord. My head is lifted up.
Above my enemies. Amen.
That's right. Next chapter over, not going too far. Psalms 28 and 7. The Lord is my strength and my shield. He's my strength and my shield. He gives me the strength, but he also covers me. He protects me. He's my strength and my shield. My heart trusteth in him. I am helped. Therefore, my heart greatly rejoices. And with my song, what am I going to do? I'll praise him.
Praise!
I'll praise him. Thank you, Lord. Psalms 30 and 10. 10 through 12. Hear, O Lord, and have mercy upon me, Lord. Be thou my helper. Thou hast turned for me my mourning into dancing. That's the two extremes.
Amen.
Mourning being really, really sad, dancing being happy and joyful.
Preach.
My mourning into dancing. Turn my mourning into dancing. Woo! My mourning into dancing. Thou hast put off my sackcloth and girded me with gladness. That's what he, see, this is what he does. To the end that my glory may sing praises to thee. And be not, and not be silent. O Lord my God, I will give thanks unto thee forever. Not for a small period of time.
Forever.
Not for most of the time, but forever. All of the time. All of the time. All of the time. Thank you, Lord. 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 So now we're going to go to Psalm 50, verses 22 and 23. Now consider this. Let's consider it. So now consider this. Ye that forget God, ye that forget God, lest I tear you in pieces, and tear, and there be no, and there be no to deliver, and there be none to deliver. Whosoever offereth praise. See, that's what it does. You understand me? That's what it does. It glorifies him.
Thank you, Jesus.
So when we come into the house of God and we're sitting down, so to speak, sitting on our hands, it says it's glorifying him. Glorifying him.
Preach, Bishop.
That's what it's about.
Preach, Bishop.
And to him that ordereth his conversation aright, will I show the salvation of God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Psalms 92, verse 1. It is good. It is a good thing. It is a good thing not to cheer for your favorite celebrity or basketball star. It's not saying that. It didn't say that. It's a good thing to cheer for a slam dunk. It's a good thing to see your favorite celebrity.
Ew.
It didn't say that. Listen to what he said. Listen to what it said. It is a good thing.
Amen.
It is a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord. A good thing to give thanks unto the Lord and to sing praises.
Yay!
To show forth thy loving kindness in the morning and thy faithfulness every night.
Preach.
That's what he does. That's what he does.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Upon an instrument of 10 strings and upon the psaltery, upon the harp with a solemn sound, for thou, Lord, hast made me glad through thy works.
Preach.
Through thy works.
Preach.
You made me glad.
Woo!
What is the song? He hath made me glad. He hath made me glad.
I will rejoice, for he has made me glad.
That's right. Hey. His works. His works.
Thank you.
His works. Right? Has made him glad.
Thank you, Jesus.
Wow. Made me glad through thy works. I will triumph in the works of thy hand. I will triumph not in the works of my hands, but in the works of thy hands.
Preach.
And of thy hands. O Lord, how great are thy works. And thy thoughts are very deep. Thy thoughts are very deep.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thy thoughts are very deep.
Amen.
Yes. Woo. We are blessed. We're blessed.
We are blessed.
We're blessed. And you know what? You determine your blessings.
We're blessed.
You determine your blessings. You determine it. You determine your blessings. You determine it. Hebrews 13 and 15. By him, therefore, let us offer the sacrifice. Let us offer the sacrifice of praise. Listen to this.
Amen.
In honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ. So the thing about it is that's what we are to be doing. That's what it's about.
Amen.
That's what it's about. That's what it's about right there.
Amen.
So you go through them trials. You go through them trials. The heat's turned up. And it's going to lead you to praise.
Amen.
It's going to lead you to praise. It's going to lead you to praise.
Teach us.
Thank you, Lord. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. All right. 1 Peter 2 and 9. But ye are a chosen generation. Listen to this. Feel good about who you are.
Amen.
Know your place in God.
Preach.
Know your place in God. Feel good about who you are. But ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation,
royal.
A peculiar people, that you should show forth the praises of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Of him who have called you, who have called you. Now listen to this. This is why we do what we do. This is why we do what we do. This is it right here. Who have called you out of darkness into his marvelous light.
Marvelous light. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Called you out of darkness. You weren't walking right. You weren't talking right. You weren't acting right. You weren't doing the right thing. You weren't treating people the right way. But he called you out of that into his marvelous light. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Got a last one.
Yeah.
Got a last one. Thank the Lord.
Revelations.
Thank the Lord. Revelations 19, verses 5 through 7. And a voice came out of the throne. Praise. Instructed to do that. All ye his servants, and ye that fear him, both small and great. And I heard, as it were, the voice of a great multitude, and as the voice of many waters, and as the voice of mighty thundering, saying, Alleluia! For the Lord God omnipotent reigneth. Let him be glad and rejoice. Let us be glad and rejoice and give honor to him, for the marriage of the Lamb is come, and his wife had made herself ready.
Preach.
Who's the wife? I know I'm a husband, but what am I? He's the groom. We're the wife. The church is the wife.
Amen.
Right? The church is the bride.
Preach.
The church is the bride. Jesus is the bridegroom. He's the groom. The church is the bride. So we make ourselves ready to receive our groom.
Amen.
Almighty God, you're such a great God.
Amen.
And you're mighty and righteous, holy and just. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Open wide. Hallelujah.
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 Jesus. He will always be there. He will never leave. People can't always be with you when you need them, but Jesus will always be there. And as long as you got King Jesus, you don't need anybody else. My little sister Priscilla loves this song.
Rub your hand. You're good.
Okay. I've been lied on, lied on, cheating, cheating, talked about.
Oh.
selection at this time, and it's a song that Donna used to usually sing, but she said she wanted to sing the other song today, so I'll sing it. Can you use someone who's finally surrendered all? Can you use someone who's willing to hear your call? Can you
Jacob.
He's that same God now. He's that same God now. And those miracles he did then, he can still do now. So no matter what people do and what comes up in life, enemies, you know, whatever, it's really easy to show love to people that you love and care for. But those people that you can't stand, that work your last nerve and do it on purpose,
amen,
you still have to love them.
Amen.
You still have to show love for them. You still have to pray for them. It doesn't mean, oh, well, I just cut in my eyes at them. You know, I didn't say anything to them. I just rolled my, that's still not showing them love. You run into them at the grocery store. Speak Jesus to them. If you see them, speak nothing. Jesus spoke the word of God to the devil. And who's worse than the devil? The devil is the ultimate worst. Speak Jesus to them.
It is written.